You can follow up yourself right after.
Yeah. So let's see. Como's still not picking his character, but I'm going to guess Cloud, because why wouldn't you, right?
Yep.
And he could go Sonic. And you might even see the Sonic come out if Charlie takes this first game, but you got to get there first.
Mm-hmm. But here we go. Game one. We are moving on to Smashville. Of course, yes, it's the stage. 60% of the time people are going to be going to. And Charlie helping out Como put on that quick 7% and a little faster to get to limit.
Just immediate lasers opening up. Why not? That's the Fox Classic right there. Not the up air. The laser to start out the game.
I like that from Charlie. Getting that one single up tilt going into the grab. Has Como back off stage.
Oh my god, this is bad.
One more?
This is bad.
But
this
he has
might
limit.
Be the stock.
Como able to get back. Limit definitely helping him out, giving him that snap, and he is back onto the stage with Charlie playing so well, not giving Como any type of opening to get anything established.
He's putting on a clinic right now. He's got Como so far, almost a minute into the game, 90% of the time he's been at the ledge.
Como got that jab combo, trying to for a single cross slash as well, but Charlie, I love the spacing he's playing. He's getting the hits that he can, and then immediately backing off, knowing that if he goes in a little too hard, he's gonna get hit by one of those stray aerials that clouds usually throw out.
Single laser, so cheeky, and he's still in a great position right now where cross slash shouldn't kill him unless it's like right by the ledge, but he's definitely gonna have to make Como exhaust his limit as soon as he can. He gets an up tilt by the ledge. Uh-oh, wow, that up tilt beating out the downer. Really great positioning from Charlie, too.
Yeah, just barely out the way of the hitbox for it. But, ooh, he has to be careful, still at this ledge. Limit is on deck, gonna jump right underneath, going to the other side, but it doesn't really change much, but he does get the platform.
Really, really smart, though. Going to the other side made it just a little bit more difficult for Como to get this edge guard. Oh, my God, the spacing was just a little bit off. Shielding the cross slash, up smash, not going to close it out.
The forward tilt clanking with the side B attempt that Charlie was tossing out. Send Como right back off stage, but Charlie struggling to take away this stock. And the dash attack, going to do it for Como Rikiri.
God, from across the stage, 136% on Como Rikiri. I mean, Charlie was looking incredibly dominant at the very beginning, but was not able to close out the stock. Maybe playing a little bit too safe.
I mean, that's just that cloud effect. Yes, you can put on that percent, but if you're unable to take these stocks, Cloud will make you pay.
And it's just a scary thing because, I mean, he's playing safe with good reason, right? Up smash, getting the new get-up attack, going to be the stock for Charlie, not taking any percent, really prime. But, yeah, having limit on deck for Cloud, it makes everything really scary for your opponent. They're going to want to play safe the entire time, even if they're, you know, in the lead. Or especially if they don't have a lead, that's like,
definitely.
I'm going to die at anything.
Yeah, it's still going on. I mean, both these characters, if they get knocked off stage, they can lose the stock very quickly. But look at this, only 11%, 13% now after a couple more of these hits, separating them, and Como exploding right now, trying to follow up off of that nair. Going a little too deep, but Charlie unable to get past the platform.
I think he was trying to go for a fair right there to drag him down. He was in the right positioning for it. The platform got in the way.
Como just caught in the vortex, even hitting the balloon.
Charlie with a chance. He's got the jab by the ledge. Nuh-uh.
Well, he ended up messing up his perfect pivot. He might pay for it. Now he's at the ledge. Limit is on deck. Are we going to see cross slash? No. Como holding on to it a little more now. Trying to go for the backer, but finds himself right back off stage.
Back off stage. Oh, my God. All the whiffs in the world. Oh, jump to the other side.
There's a re-grab. Oh, but Como not ready for it. Expecting a side B.
Uh-oh. Oh, Charlie's moving right now. He's got him off stage again. He tried to go for the immediate. Oh,
cross
my God.
Slash,
tech.
Yes.
There we go.
Charlie, another tech.
He's
over.
He
gets
the
stock after it.
With the side B. He pops off. Game one is all his, baby.
Oh, my goodness. Charlie. You do not test Charlie at trying to tech. All he does is tech no matter what. You guys seen the videos.
Yeah.
Do not mess with this man.
Zero, man. Como Rikiri, it doesn't matter. He will tech all of your attempts to kill him below the stage. He will make it back 100% of the time.
Well, all right, here we go. Charlie taking the first game. Como's counterpick just running it straight back to Smashville. But I will say, if Como is able to play as he did in very late in his first stock, he might be able to take this one away.
I mean,
right away.
That was a close game. I mean, he played it perfectly.
Yo, but Charlie already just exploding in the early goings. 44% looking like the early goings of that first match. But can Charlie seal up these stocks quickly?
Yeah, an average Fox player honestly would have died at all three attempts of those where Charlie was able to tech. But Here we go. He's opening up only 12% on himself and still just building up so much damage on Komo. 78% with that single laser. So cheeky.
Yeah, yet again, just trying to put on some more percent, making sure Komo burns the limit, getting another up tilt into the up air. Ooh, but gonna get clipped by the down air of Komo.
This is where Charlie wants to play aggressive, because Komo still does not have limit. Oh my god, the tech again! That was death for anyone else. Luckily, he did not get the sweet spot to send him straight down.
Komo not ready for the last side B that Charlie ended up throwing out. Has him back onto the stage. Ooh, just barely jumping away from that backer, but the up smash catching the landing.
This is his chance. 64% on his first life still. Only one game away from sending Komori Kiri to the loser's bracket.
Charlie playing so well right now, riding the momentum from that first game. And now Komo trying to slow it down a little bit, but he can't stay on that platform too long. Charlie already making it prevalent, like, yo, if you just want to be up there, I'm going to give you a quick 39.
Other side. Nope. He's going to mix it up this time.
Yeah, no, he didn't get enough distance on it.
Yeah, here we go. He's going to make it back to the ledge one time. He's trapped a little bit. He's going to retreat to the platform. Komo just trying to shark with these up airs. The shield's looking pretty small from Charlie. He's going to want to watch that.
Oh! Side B straight into the cross slash Komo, evening this up. Only 39% racked up onto him. But
a little bit sloppy from Charlie, but I mean, he's still in a good position right now.
I mean, Komo spacing out so well with these falling up airs, using the backer a little bit more, and I like these up tilts, canceling out the aerial attempts that Charlie's tossing out right now.
Starting off a little bit of a vortex of his own. Fox has got one, so does Cloud. Here we go. Breaking out of the combo with the up air.
Yeah, falling down a little bit too quickly, and Charlie went for his own up air. He's going to get caught by one. Getting caught by the down smash now as well. Good wave beam. He has limit on deck yet again. We're going to see another cross slash. No, just spacing out these aerials. Beefy. Aerial and after aerial.
Still going to make it back. What? He's going to go
one
for
more time?
Oh,
no.
Yeah, no. Not that time.
Komo with the answer.
Man, getting was able to bring that all the way back after incredible. I mean, Charlie took that first stock with only 60% on himself. So it was his game to lose.
Yeah, but now here we go. 1-1 is the set. And we're on Charlie's counter pick. I'm assuming Lylat or FD would be banned. I'm only saying this because Cloud does quite well on Dreamland. And yes, so Dreamland and Battlefield still on deck, and Charlie opting to go to Dreamland. And here we go, guys. Game three. Winner of this is going to move on through the bracket. Let's go ahead and toss up your ones if you want Charlie. Toss up some twos if you want Komo.
And as in regards to this stage pick, I personally think it's probably like even for both characters. It's maybe more of just a comfort pick for Charlie here.
No, I mean, they both do quite well on it. As we know, Cloud having the disjoints from his up air and the sword can take advantage of the platforms. But, you know, Fox does the same exact thing with the ladder we've already seen from Larry, from Charlie, from Eon. Like, there's so many Foxes that are out here.
There you go, tech roll away. Gonna avoid any potential danger. Back air sending Komo far off stage. He's got a burn limit now.
Oh, my goodness. Charlie trying to get that trump, but unfortunately not going to get it. He doesn't have a jump. Now he's getting hit off back and forth.
No tech. Uh-oh, he's going to no jump here. Yep. All right. Luckily, he gets hit back onto the stage. Komo helping him out a little bit.
Yeah, Charlie definitely happy about that one. I think his double jump is burned. Has to immediately up B.
Oh, my God,
that's
going to
be the stock. Did he go too deep? No, he's fine.
Oh, my God.
We're good.
I was like, why? He was gone. He had burned his jump. 92%, 106 now at that back air. Still... Oh my god, Charlie, how are you gonna find his way back to the stage?
He's finding his way back to the stage, but he's finding his way into these hits from Komo Rikiri, sealing it out, not gonna land that downer, but gonna land yet another forward tilt.
He's getting a little bit too trigger happy with these side Bs, and there's the cross slash great.
Don't get pineappled, okay.
Yeah, that would be unfortunate. No percent on Komo before he was able to find that stock. Again, it's an incredibly tight match. That last hit of forward air, this is gonna be it. Oh my god, he went for the forward tilt.
Oh, he doesn't have a jump. Oh, he's able to grab onto the ledge at the very last second. And here we go, these up airs not allowing Charlie to get back onto the stage. Here we go again, 41 all in this last game of this set. Charlie and Komo knows what is on the line, trying to try their darnest to come out on top.
Not much percentage separating these two players, but Charlie's got the strings on lock.
Oh my goodness, the movement coming up from Charlie, up dancing on him right now, looking like he has ice skates.
Oh my god, he had that roll read, but he's just misspaced himself just a tiny bit.
But now he's back off stage.
Oh my god, and this is going to be a forward air. It doesn't go for the up air. Just put on a little bit more damage.
Komo still has limits, so Charlie definitely has to be careful, sitting at 68%. It is burned now.
Oh my god!
No, Como try to go for another down smash there if you guys saw the start of it. But Charlie in the driver's seat just needs one good hit, and that's gonna be it! Back and forth they go, and Charlie's right back off stage. Como in the driver's seat trying to land these backers, running right away, and I like that from Como.
Luckily, Como did not have any meter on deck, so he was not able to pressure Charlie as hard. Dash attack. Oh my god, that's so strong. He's got to be careful. He's got to find this kill, but he doesn't want to pull the trigger prematurely.
Backer! No, that's going to be a Como right here. Barely get out.
Yeah, backer.